this morning in Going Places, if you've caught the travel bug during Halloween season, we've got some haunted houses that you may want to check out. Here to fill us in on all this spooky scoop, is the senior editor for Travel Zoo, Gabe Saglier. Good morning, Gabe.
Good morning. Good to be with you.
Thanks so much. Well, you know, we know that Travel Zoo is the best at giving us some world travel advice. But tell us now about some tips that are Halloween related.
Well, you know, if you're going to spend the night at a presumably haunted hotel during the course of the year, this is probably the time you would do that. There are dozens of hotels across the country that, you know, where things presumably go bump in the night. Some hotels embrace this and come up with these really fun, you know, creative packages. Some of them don't. So you got to seek out the ones that do. And if you're going to be staying at one of these places overnight on Halloween night, you've got to plan ahead and book well in advance and be willing to pay slightly higher rates. Also, if you're going to be doing like an amusement park or a haunted house in your neighborhood, two bits of advice. One, make sure it's age appropriate if you're bringing the kids. They usually are very specific about the age appropriate aspect of these houses. And also go online to get discounts on things like tickets and even parking, because oftentimes you know, their online sites are a neat little clearing site for deals before you actually show up to the front door.
Yeah, that's true. Well, good
but
tips.
You know what? We came up with a couple. A couple of well-known properties across the country, some presumably haunted hotels, should you consider a haunted getaway. And first of all, in Boston, not all that far away, the Omni Parker House Hotel, the longest continuously running hotel in the country. The Boston Cream Pie was invented here, but presumably Harvey Parker, the founder who died in 1884, still roams the lobby there, asking guests how their stay was. And a lot of authors used to stay here, and Henry Wadsworth Longfellow, presumably, his ghost can still be seen taking the elevator to the third floor where he used to have his favorite room. So keep that in mind. Otherwise, though, a fantastic, beautiful, upscale hotel to stay in Boston right on the Freedom Trail. You may have also read the book The Shining by Stephen King. Stephen King stayed in a place called the Stanley Hotel in Estes Park, Colorado when he wrote this book in room 217. The made-for-TV version of The Shining was actually shot at this hotel. So you can stay in room 217, presumably haunted, but really it's the fourth floor of this hotel where you see most of the paranormal activity. And these guys have a package called the Ghost Adventure Package. Starts at about $249, where you can spend the night in a guaranteed fourth floor room and you get your own K2 meter to actually gauge for paranormal entities on your own there at the Stanley Hotel in Estes Park, Colorado. And finally, in Southern California, the very famous Queen Mary, which over the course of World War II was a vessel for Allied troops and was a beautiful transatlantic ship for a couple of decades. Now it's a four-star hotel there in Long Beach, California. But paranormal experts say that at least 200 ghosts still inhabit the ship. Screams can be heard coming from machine rooms down below. They have this beautiful Art Deco pool where presumably you still see wet footprints when nobody's there. And you can do a tour for two, a paranormal tour for two between now and February. It's an after-hours experience with a paranormal guide, and you get to check out the you know, most haunted haunts on the Queen Mary for just $39 for two people. So
you've got it all there, Gabe.
Here as well. It is a fun place to stay.
You've got it all, including right around the corner from us in Boston. All right, so one last deal, though, that we definitely want to hear about is if we don't want something that's too scary, you've got a great deal in Jamaica. Tell us about it.
Yeah, so this is if you want to just avoid the spooky hoopla altogether. We're still in shoulder season. The travel industry is still pumping out some good deals out there. Caribbean prices will go up starting Christmas week and into the new year. But between now and the mid to late December, some great deals should be had. This is a place called the Sunset Beach Resort and Spa in Montego Bay, Jamaica, with airfare out of Providence and a four-night stay here at this all-inclusive resort, $819. That's more than $500 off what rates will be come the height of the winter season. And kids 12 and under stay and eat for free here, so you just pay for their airfare to get them down there. So family-friendly, all-inclusive, and a beautiful beachside property there in Montego Bay.
Sign me up. Thanks, Gabe, so much for all of your spooky tips and also those ideas in Jamaica. And if you want even more travel tips from Travel Zoo, we're going to post them on our website. It's the Roadshow page on WPRI.com.